I was about 10 years old. I was taking a shortcut home through the forest when a strange wind began to blow. It was such a strange sound, almost like words calling me. Everything was moving so fast. I couldn't move. I couldn't breathe. God had given me a message. A message to deliver.
What was the message?
I must save France from her enemies and bring her back into the hands of God.
Follow me!
She was on her white horse facing the whole English army, and she drove them away.
That's too easy.
We must be absolutely certain that she is not an instrument of the devil.
The girl is crazy.
We are, of course, enormously grateful for your past efforts. But now your task is done.
I want that girl burned.
You are not helping yourself by refusing to submit to our judgment.
You, who claim to be my judges, you be careful!
You think that God made the right decision to take an ignorant girl to save the kingdom of France?
Who are you to even think you can know the difference between good and evil?
Pleased to bring you our feature presentation.
Sonny, it's your dad. You were sleeping.
No, hey, man. I was exercising.
Bullshit. You were sleeping.
No, I wasn't.
This kid won't stop lying to me. You still act like you're six.
Oh, yeah. Okay, Dad. I act like I'm six.
Any luck finding a job where you can work more than one day a week?
I've been looking.
Looking doesn't pay the rent, kid.
Hey, all the money I won from the cab accident is kicking ass in the stock market, so relax.
Yeah, well, don't blow it all on worthless crap.
I won't.
You know what you should spend it on? Your bar exam.
You're the lawyer in the family. I ain't taking a damn bar exam. I got too much other shit going on in my life.
I don't know what the hell happened to you.
Okay.
Anyway, how are things going with your girlfriend? What's it? Vanessa?
Things are going fine.
Shit!
I gotta go.
Shit! Damn, turn off the alarm clock again.
No. I mean, yes, I did, but I thought you needed more sleep, Vanessa.
I knew I shouldn't have stayed here. That was a real jerk thing to do. Thanks a lot.
What are you doing? Why are you going to work? It's Sunday.
I'm not going to work. I'm going to brunch with some potential clients. That's how a party planner gets business, by meeting people and making contacts.
Meet with me. Come on, I'll order in from Cozy's. We'll have fun.
I am sick of Cozy's. You order in from there all the time. The delivery guy's like your best friend.
Well, he happens to be pretty damn nice.
Oh, God.
This is a rough patch of my life right now, all right? Syracuse is 0-3. I got those medical problems.
Medical problems? A cab runs over your foot 2 years ago. You spend one night in the hospital.
First of all, that cab was huge. And a jury decided that one night of pain was worth $200,000. So there you go.
Whatever.
What the hell's the matter with you? Why are you being so nuts to me lately?
Because you refuse to move on to the next phase of your life. I, on the other hand, would like to have a family someday, but I need someone that I can rely on, not just a playmate.
What do you need, a father figure? Stop pulling your sister's hair!
You know what? I'm gonna go to Syracuse to see my mother. I'll be back on Wednesday.
What are you talking about?
I had a call for a delivery in building, but I think it was crank call. Want some chocolate cake?
It's a bad time, man. You come back later. I'll Indian wrestle you.
You're going down, sucker.
Yeah, well, we'll see about that.
Okay, peace out.
What do you mean you're going to Syracuse?
Because I need time to think, and so do you.
What do I need to think about?
Your life, and why there's any reason for me to be a part of it.
All right.
While you're at it, why don't you think about getting a real job?
I got a real job! Patrick Ewing, nice job.
Hey, Sonny.
What's up, buddy boy?
Yeah. I'm out the door.
All right.
Hey, pal. Where you going?
Manhattan,
you want to take me with you?
I guess.
All right, hold on to your money. Later on, pal.
Okay, take care of Sonny. See ya.
Cadillac, I love it.
To be alone. I was always thinking of games that I was playing, trying to make best of my time, but only love can break your heart.
Surprise! Just ignore him. It's only Sunny. It's only Sunny.
Yeah, it's only me. It's only me. What's going on?
Corinne's throwing a surprise going away party for Kevin.
Well, why didn't she tell me about it? The roommate has a right to know.
Because she knew you'd tell him and ruin the surprise.
No, I wouldn't.
Hey, surprise!
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 Surprise.
What's going on?
We wasted the good surprise on you.
All right.
Is this your handiwork?
I guess.
See you in 3 hours.
Good to see you stiffs out anyway. What have you been doing? Last 3 weeks have been crazy at work, man. I've been in Denver, Dallas, San Francisco.
I've been sleeping in the office. We're going to trial on the securities fraud case.
Honey, it was a great surprise. I was totally shocked.
No, you were. And I worked so hard on this.
Need some help?
Honey, your sister's here.
Hey, sweetie.
I hate Sunny.
My client's out $7 million, and all we can sue on is breach of contract.
Maybe you can try suing under the Foreign Corrupt Practices Act.
I gotta get back to the office. Sonny, you're the king.
Right on.
Mikey, pleasure. I'll see you at home.
All right.
I'll walk you.
I gotta admit, I'm still a little weird of that when they kiss.
Why? They're gay. That's what gay guys do.
Yeah, I know, but they were like brothers to us back in school.
They're still like our brothers, our very, very gay brothers.